99% of beginners are practicing wrong, which leads to months of stalled progress because they don't understand the two most important things for growth: what to practice and how to practice. I'm going to show you the top five exercises for beginners that will help you build a solid foundation. Plus, I'll point out some common beginner mistakes you should avoid. We're going to start simple and then move up a level with each exercise, so see if you can keep up as we go along. This first exercise is a great starting point because it gets our right and our left hand working together and it builds finger strength and independence. I always start with this first in my lessons, but I still use it today as a warm up myself. You're gonna start on the low E string, place your first finger on the first fret, your second finger on the second fret, your third finger on the third fret, and your pinky on the fourth fret. One common mistake I see is people using this part of the finger, but if you use the tip of your finger, it's gonna help the notes come out more clear and it'll help you move around easier. So you're gonna play that 1, 2, 3, 4 on every string, and then when you get to the top, you're gonna do the whole thing in reverse. 4, 3, 2, 1, 4, 3, 2, 1, all the way back down. So here's the whole thing. Now, if you're just starting out, this might be too fast, so just go as slow as you need to. Speed is not really important right now. The most important thing is that every note comes out clear, and once you get that, you can start bumping up the tempo. Also, if that's too much of a stretch, you can just start it higher up on the neck, like on the 5th or 7th fret, and it'll be way easier. This next exercise is probably the most popular on guitar. It's super simple, sounds awesome, and it can be used in pretty much any style. It's the minor pentatonic scale. We're gonna do this in G minor, so start with the first finger on G, the 3rd fret on the low E string. And then you're gonna play the 6th fret with your pinky on the low E string. Then the next 3 strings, you're gonna go 3, 5, 3, 5, 3, 5. And then the last 2 strings are the same as the first string. 3, 6, 3, 6. And then you're gonna reverse it and go back down. 6, 3, 6, 3, 5, 3, and so on. So here's the whole thing. Up next is the most important thing you can learn to have a really good understanding of music in general and how it all works together. We're not gonna do a deep dive into music theory right now, but I'll talk a little bit more about that in future videos. For now, I just wanna show you the pattern and get your fingers moving around the neck. There's several different ways we can play this, but for now, I wanna start with using open strings. So this is the major scale in the key of C. Right, now here it is in the key of G. Mastering scales is super important. They're gonna help you understand where the notes are on the neck and how to get around no matter what key you're in, which will help you come up with cool chords, know where to go when you're soloing, and just have a better understanding of how it all works together. But even just used as an exercise, they can help develop your dexterity and speed in your fingers. So we're gonna do the major scale again, but this time we're gonna use 3 notes per string. Let's start with getting your hand in the right position. We're gonna be in the key of G, so this first note is gonna be on the 3rd fret on the low E string, and then the last note is gonna be on the 7th fret with your pinky on the low E string. So place your thumb right over the 4th fret and pull it down a little bit so you can make sure that you're getting that stretch. If your thumb is too high, it's gonna be really hard to get that stretch. Keep your hand in this position the entire time and don't let it change. Also, pay close attention to which fingers I'm using when I do this. All right, here goes. Now, if that's too much of a stretch, once again, you can just move it up higher on the neck and do the exact same pattern, but start on a different note. So if we started that on the 7th fret on the low E string, which is a B, then you'd be playing the B major scale. And that's one thing that's super cool about guitar versus like piano or saxophone, for example, is the scales are movable. So it's the exact same pattern, just starting on a different note. Make sure you're not ignoring tempo when you practice these. Use a metronome and pick a tempo that you can play the whole thing at, but make sure that every note is still coming out clear. So you might need to start pretty slow, and that's totally fine, but you really need to be working on your timing. It's super important. All right, what I love about this last one is it's not only a great exercise to build your chops, but you can also use it for melodic ideas when you're soloing. This is one of my favorite patterns, and you can use it with any scale or mode, but for now, we're gonna use the G major scale that I just showed you. You're gonna start by playing the first four notes of the scale. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you're gonna start on the second note of that scale and go up four notes from there. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then you're gonna start on the third note of that scale and go up four notes from there. So here are those three. And then you're just gonna repeat that pattern all the way to the top. So here's the whole thing. So now we've got a great foundation to start building on, but we've only got a few tools in our tool belt. We've still got a lot of work to do, like chords, strumming, picking, music theory, and the list goes on. Also, I want to go way more in depth on how to practice, because I think that's the most important thing, and you can totally wreck your playing if you're not practicing the right way. So if you found this video helpful and you want to see more, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you next time. Peace.